Hi guys, welcome to this 10th tutorial in this series of programming PEEK microcontroller with Flowcode for absolute beginners. In this tutorial, we're gonna learn how to use 7-segment displays with Flowcode. The 7-segment display is the earliest type of electronic display that uses 7 LEDs bars arranged in a way that can be used to show the numbers from 0 to 9. Actually, there are 8 segments if you count the decimal point as well. These devices are commonly used in digital clocks, electronic meters, counters, signaling, and other equipment for displaying numeric data only. Let's say, for example, if I want to display the digit 8, then I'll have to switch on all the seven LEDs. These bars are normally referred to by letters A to G. The top bar is A, then B, C, D, E, F, G, then the decimal point. Let's say if I want to display 8, then all these 7 LEDs bars should be switched on. If I want to display the digit 3, then only the bar A, B, C, D, and G should be switched on. The 7-segment displays are available in 2 configurations. We've got the common anode and the common cathode. In common anode, all the internal LEDs anode are connected together and they should be connected to the positive supply or to the common pin. And in common cathode, all the cathode are connected together and they should be connected to ground or to the common pin. Let's go back to Flowcode and see how we can use a 7-segment display. To insert a 7-segment component, go to the output group and select 7-segment 1 if you want to select a 1-digit 7-segment display, or you can click the 7-segment 4 if you want to select the quad 7-segment, which is a group of 4 7-segment displays in one package. We just drag this to this side. If I select the 7-segment component and click on the external properties, here I can select the configuration of the 7-segment display, if it's going to be used in common anode or common cathode. Let us select it in common cathode. I can select the color of my 7-segment display. We've got green, we've got yellow, we've got blue and red. I'm going to leave the default red value. This slider is just to increase the size of the 7-segment display, the way it's going to be displayed on the panel, but it's not going to affect the code that is going to be generated. Okay, let me click OK. Click on the connection properties. Here you can choose on which port of the PEEK you're going to connect your 7-segment display. By default, the 7-segment display is connected to port B and the common pin is connected to port A, bit 3. I'm just going to leave the default values, but if you need to connect it to a different port, then you can select a different port. You can even select the individual pin bit. Okay, I'm just going to leave these default values. Click done. If you click on the quad 7-segment display, the edit component properties is basically the same as the single digit. But if you click on the connection, you can see we've got 4 common pins, because for each digit to be switched on, its common pin should be switched on as well. You can select the port to which you're going to connect your quad 7-segment display. Let me select port B and the common pin. I can use the port A. The first common pin is going to be connected to port A, bit 0, the second one to bit 1, the third one to bit 2, and the fourth one to bit 4. Okay, click done. To use a 7-segment display with Flowcode, it's very easy. All you need to do is insert your component micro, Select the 7-segment display you're gonna use. We've got basically two micros, the show digit and the clear digit. The show digit takes two parameters, the value, which is gonna be the digit you're going to display, and the decimal point to determine whether you're gonna display the decimal point or not. Let us display the digit 5. If I put 1 to the decimal point, then the decimal point is gonna be enabled, is gonna be switched on, it's gonna be visible. But if I put 0, then it's gonna be disabled. Click OK, and if I run my project, then you can see the digit 5 is displayed on the 7-segment display. If I set the decimal point value to 1, click run, then you can see the decimal point is displayed on the 7-segment display. Okay. The clear digit is basically to disable the common pin of the 7-segment display, which is basically gonna switch off the 7-segment display. This is a good feature, especially when you are using more than one 7-segment display. So you can select each individual 7-segment display by switching the other ones off. Okay. This is basically how you can display any digit on the 7-segment display. If I want to display the digit 1, then you can just enter the value of 1. I'm gonna disable the decimal points, click OK, run, and you can see 1 is displayed on the 7-segment display. Let us create a simple project, a simple decimal counter to display 0 to 9 at an interval of 1 second. I'm gonna need a while one loop so that my program can loop continuously. Gonna need a decision statement. Let us create variable that is gonna hold the value of the digit to be displayed. I've created a byte variable named counter and initialize it to 0 so it can start with the value of 0. Let me use the variable. Then I'm gonna say if counter it's greater than 9, then I'm gonna reset the value of my counter to 0 so that when it reaches 9, it starts to 0 again. Okay. Otherwise, when the value of counter is below or equals to 9, then I can display the value of my counter show digit. I'm gonna display counter and I'm gonna switch off the decimal point. Okay, then a 1 second delay, and that's all. So my program is gonna loop continuously. When it's gonna start, the value of counter is gonna be 0, so I'm gonna display 0. After 1 second delay, it's gonna loop again. Okay, I'll have to increment the value of counter. Counter goes to counter plus 1. So it can keep on incrementing. It's gonna start at 0, then 1, then 2. When it's gonna be more than 9, then I'm gonna reset counter to 0 so it can start from 0 again. Let us run our project and see. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, then 0 again. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel to receive more tutorials. Thank you.